Good evening, Pastor.
Good evening.
Thank you, Church. It's a great honor to be here sharing my testimony.
Right.
谢谢大家今晚抽出宝贵的时间来听小弟的见证。谢谢。
So what happened next?
Then after that, I called him. I said that, you know, things just get worse. So he came to my house and did a lot of things. So, you know, to change the colors, to change my bag, direction, everything. Okay. So, but it doesn't work. Things just get worse. Okay. I received from the bank, say that I'm owing 3 months of housing loan that I have to pay. If not, they will seize my house.
Okay.
I even go further. Okay. My friend brought me to another one. This one, wow, performed in the night. Very scary. Okay. There I can see, you know, chicken and black cat. They kill them and was told to drink the blood. Okay.
Okay.
I do whatever they told me because I'm so desperate that I want to clear all this, you know, that things that, you know, sway. After that, the following weeks, after drinking the blood and mixed with, I think, alcohol or something like that, I was caught drunkard driving. My driving license was suspended for 2 years.
Two years.
Okay,
and then things got worse and worse. You were sued by the landowner of that resort.
I haven't gone further. I haven't gone to Thailand. You know, those things can help me. I will go and pray this and that. You know, upon my return, I was summoned by my landlord. Okay, they sued me out from the premises, the resort country club, and I have a total loss of $1.2 million.
That was a lot.
Wow. When these things break out, okay, you know, like Hokkien, they say, 求斗老高耍. Everybody, boom, you know. Wow. You know,
so although you were not searching for God, God used somebody, a Christian friend, kept talking to you. And you were irritated.
This long lost friend, okay, called me up one day and said that, I read an article about you. Okay, you are quite jialat, you know. Wow, with all this debt and that. How are you going? I said, don't talk lah, you know. Then slowly, and these Christian friends of mine, okay, try to talk me into Christianity. I say, come on lah, don't talk about your God, okay. I pray to so many gods. Bolang help wah. If your God really can help me, give him money. So I will believe you. I will trust you. I will follow you. You will do whatever you tell me to do. You
see, just give me money.
It doesn't work that way.
Yeah. Okay. But this person refused to give up. Then when you began to open up to Jesus Christ since 2003.
And 2003, accepted Christ.
Right.
Yes.
And then when your heart began to change, towards Christ, your circumstances also began to change. Not all at once.
Yes, not all at once.
Stage by stage.
Okay. During that time, during the baptism, everything, okay, I still, you know, no idea what is going on. Because then I met a few of the Christian friends. They are kind enough to give me some of the, you know,
Bible studies and to read.
Okay, then they say they have been praying for me. So the first miracle that takes place is, okay, my partner,
business partner,
called me up one day and said that they would like to settle out of court with a settlement of $210,000. Wow, I was shocked, you know.
It was far below,
yes.
But still, better than nothing.
You know, better than nothing.
Okay.
I took the money, I settled the bank OD and some interest for the housing loan. Okay. And the second miracle that happens is, after a few months, the debtors call me up and say that they will not come after me no more. Because the family finally realized that I'm not the one who signed upon the purchase of all the goods, everything. They will go after the other two parties and say, hallelujah. Wow, you know, heavy burden, you know, 酒头薄可了, hallelujah, you know, want all the sway away.
Praise God.
Praise God.
And the third thing?
And the third thing is, for my career, okay, I was signed on an outsourced entertainment company that give me more opportunities. Take me 1 year to pay back the loan to the loan shark, the principal plus the interest. Hallelujah.
And then in the process of time, the gambling habit, the smoking habit,
slowly,
the drinking
slowly,
habit.
Slowly. Yeah, everything slowly.
Now today,
slowly.
You don't have an urge.
I don't have the urge.
To gamble, to smoke, to drink. And then the demonic attacks. Switch off all the lights.
I can switch off the light and sleep peacefully.
No more this eye looking at you. And this spiritual attack on your temper when you become so frustrated, you became another person. Isn't that wonderful? You know? You see, the Bible says, you shall know the truth.
And the truth will set me free. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Pastor.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Pastor.